Trini Girl Natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm excited to be talking about a couple items from the Sultanica Spring Bundle. So I did not get the Spring Bundle because I'm not bad, but I did get a couple items sent to me as part of a prize. I have a video coming up about how to get free products, so look out for that. But yeah, I got these two, the Sultanica Frizz Wiz Curl Defining Leave-In and the Sultanica Sprung Coil Boosting Jelly. So from the minute I got these, I knew I was going to come on and review them because I know a lot of us are really interested in Sultanica. So I knew you'd be wanting to try this out too, so I decided to just come on and show you how they worked out for me. Here I am soaking wet. I'm using the Sultanica Frizz Wiz Curl Defining Leave-In. And I have the Sprung Coil Boosting Jelly, also from Sultanica. So this is my hair before I add any product. I guess, spoiler alert, I did the other sections already. And I love this leave-in. It's kind of a really creamy, almost slimy, light consistency, but it's super moisturizing, so I love it. And it's super defining, so I guess it really does what it says in terms of that. And a little goes a long way, I would say, even though I'm heavy-handed. So, swatch the magic. I haven't even really distributed it everywhere yet. Yeah, I know I should wait longer, but like, this is so, such a good leave-in. Let me keep working it in, but it's like immediate definition and I guess frizz reduction, I don't know. Smells great, super moisturizing, defining, definitely going up to the top of the list in leave-ins for me. But not the top, but you know, up on the top in my HD pile. Alright, so this is the leave-in. I like the curl definition. I would like to try it myself sometime. I'll try not to look at the viewfinder, but it's like, sorry. Anyways. Alright, so this is the leave-in before the gel, with the leave-in alone. Love it. And now I'm gonna add the gel. I just pumped out some. So it's an interesting texture because it's not slimy. It's almost creamy like a leave-in, but I can feel a little bit of carbama in there. So it's not slimy at all. It's more creamy, I guess. This gel feels like a carbama gel, which is not my thing exactly. But I got it. Won it. Thank you, Ayo. No prize, so I'm gonna use it. At least this once. I'm not too sure about the moisture. It's not an instant thing. So we'll see tomorrow. Because I mean, the leave-in is already super moisturizing. The gel didn't seem to add anything to that. Alright, so this is it. I guess I'll have a final review for you when it dries. I love the leave-in. The gel is okay so far. Just checking the ingredients. But I'll do that when I have my hair dry and I'll jump in and I'll do the rest of this video. So the first one I tried was this Frizz Wiz Curl Defining Leave-In. And here are the ingredients. It has sugar, which my hair likes. Beet sugar. Beet sugar is also humectant. Lots of humectants. Lots of defining ingredients. Of course, the humectants will help define your hair, but it also has some cellulose gum, which is also a defining ingredient. Slippery Elm and Irish Moss are great for slip, and they also provide a lot of moisture. Beet sugar provides a lot of moisture. Good stuff and all the stuff that I need. It's interesting that I don't really see oils in here. So, of course, acetyl alcohol is kind of like an oil. It's like a fatty alcohol. But I don't see a lot of oils, which is kind of surprising. Maybe that's why I like it so much, because it just really penetrated my hair. It has a light flowery scent, which I really like. I like the texture, I like how moisturizing it is. Great slip, amazing slip, and give my hair a really good definition. So I really enjoyed using this. And next we have the sprung coil boosting jelly. Here are the ingredients. I'm not too sure on the soap palmetto, I'll have to look that up. It has a wheat germ oil, which is really good for your hair, especially now in the summer because it has SPF, high SPF, so it can help to protect your hair from sun damage. It has cellulose gum, which is a defining agent, and sodium carbamate, which is like the gelling agent and eco styler, and then like just ginseng and a couple other stuff. When I saw the carbamate, I was kind of disappointed because, you know, I don't really buy carbamate stuff. Of course, I got this for free. I don't really buy carbamate gels except if it's eco styler, because it's just such a cheap ingredient that I'm not gonna pay $10 or whatever for this much of a gel with carbamate being the main gelling ingredient. So it does also have some cellulose gum, but just seeing that carbamate, I was like, even if I love it, I'm not gonna incorporate it into my HGs just because of that. But I was really excited to try it because everybody on Instagram is coming on with this like perfect looking hair after using this. So I thought, woo, you know, this is gonna be great. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna love it. I used it yesterday, which is Monday. So this is actually day two. The label does say medium to firm hold. It does actually feel kind of like Eco Styler in the sense that it gave me almost a light cast. It's not crunchy at all, but just a light kind of cast. It does have a slight chemical-y scent to it as well, probably even with the amount of flowery scent. I really can't say that it worked for me. So from the time that I put it on, like, I was super happy and like, hey, jumping up and down after putting on this. And when I put this on, I was like, ugh. So at first I was like, okay, the slip is okay, but my hair almost seemed to be losing moisture. Like, after I put this on, my hair was super moisturized. And when I put this on, instead of adding moisture, it kind of almost took it away. And then when I looked at my hair afterwards, I didn't see that definition. It almost kind of foams slightly in my hair, but my hair is wet and stuff foams in it sometimes, like the Camellia Rose Honey leave-in and the Giovanni Direct leave-in. So the slight foam is neither here nor there, but it did seem to take away moisture and even possibly frizz my hair compared to just the leave-in. So in terms of moisture and definition, I felt like it almost took a step back compared to when I just put the leave-in. And then this morning I woke up and my hair is frizzy, so I mean, you should be able to see that. Like, you can see the definition, but you can see the frizz right alongside it. And I usually have much better definition. Even when I just do conditioner, I think I have more definition, or less frizz, I should say. My hair felt on the dry side, frizzy, and not moisturized, not super soft like how I like when I put on a gel, especially on a natural gel or botanical gel. I like my hair to feel super soft like Giancarlo or Camille Rose. But this felt like a wannabe Eco Styler, so maybe like Eco Styler Curls and Waves, but it didn't really give me the big hair that Eco Styler Curls and Waves does either. It just, so it's not, you know, I don't know, it's not big. It's still kind of flat, and but it's frizzy. And it's not wonderful to the touch. So it isn't crunchy, so I don't hate touching it, but it's kind of a little dry and there's a slight kind of cast. And this is like a day two, and it's completely frizzy. I mean, I don't mind frizz, I don't mind shrinkage, I don't mind anything, so I'm pretty much easy to please in a sense. So I will happily rock this until wash day. I'm not that upset with it, but in terms of what I was hoping for a kind of more natural gel, I'm a little disappointed. So sorry that, but no, this, At least I don't hate my hair. I don't hate how it looks. I don't hate how it feels, but I don't love how it looks and I don't love how it feels either, so. So I guess that's it about that. But most people I saw loved it, so definitely my hair is weird. I want to ask her if she has any product testers with my kind of wiry texture, because I don't know, but I'm one of the few people, I guess, who didn't really like this. But I love this. This is a new HG. This is my new favorite Sultanicals leave-in, and this is definitely on my HG list. So, love. Yes. Not so much. So that was it. I hope it was helpful for you to see the review of these two products. Definitely let me know how it was for you if you tried it. Definitely don't be shy to try it, because I love this and most people except me love this. So definitely give it a go. So that's it. See you in the next one. Bye.